Ever since Minecraft 1.17 came out, I've been constantly refreshing the Optifine download page, hoping to finally see a shader compatible version. And I'm sure I'm not the only one. In this video, we make ourselves independent of the long and slow Optifine and install shaders without Optifine. We do this using a tool called Irish Shaders. Click on the second link in the description to go to my handwritten manual from where you can find the download button to go to the Irish Shaders download page. On this page, simply click the blue download universal jar button and the jar file will be downloaded. Your browser may display a warning for this file, but this file is 100% safe, so you can simply click the keep option. Once downloaded, this file will likely be in your downloads folder. So open your downloads folder, right click on the jar file, choose open with, and then Java. If you don't see this option, you can click on the fourth link in the description with which you can download the Java development kit, after which it should be possible. If it's still not possible, then I'll also leave a link in the description to a tool called Jarfix, after which running that tool, you will no doubt see the option to run Irish shaders with Java. When you perform the Irish shaders jar, you will see this screen. By default, the addition is on Iris and Sodium. This option doesn't work for 1.17, so change it to Iris Standalone. Change the game version to 1.17, of course, after all, that's the version we want the shaders to work on, and leave the rest of the options as they are. Click Install, and the Iris shaders will be installed. When you see the message that Iris shaders has been successfully installed, you can close this screen and delete the jar file from your downloads folder. You can now open your Minecraft launcher, and next to the green play button, click the drop-down menu to select the Iris standalone version. If you don't see the Iris standalone version listed here, you can click on the installations tab at the top and check the modded checkbox. Iris standalone should now appear in the list next to which you can click the green play button. In some cases, you need to manually add Iris standalone to the launcher. You do this by clicking the new installation button and giving this installation a name. I'll just name it patreon.com/narnicole because that's where you can support this channel and give yourself access to our survival Minecraft server, exclusively for supporters. Under version, choose Iris Fabric Loader 1.17 and then choose your desired resolution on which you want to play. I choose 1920 by 1080 here and click on create. You can see that I have now added the Iris profile to the launcher, and so I can click the green play button next to it. The launcher will give you a warning indicating that you are about to start Minecraft with mods enabled. You want shaders, so that's totally fine. So click on play again and Minecraft will be started. If you already have Optifine shaders installed, Iris will import them automatically. But if you don't have any shaders yet, I'll show you how to install them now. On the Minecraft main menu, you'll see Fabric in the bottom left, but that's because Iris is built on the Fabric mod pack. When you click on Options in the main menu and you go to Video Settings, you will now find the Shader Packs option at the bottom right. When you click on this, you can drag the shader packs directly to this screen to install them. If you don't have shader packs yet, I'll also leave a link in the description to the 5 best Minecraft shaders from which you can download shader packs. I already have 2, so I'm dragging Sildur's Vibrant Shaders to this screen, but you can also click the Open Shader Pack Folder button and drag your shaders back into this folder. When you do that, you have to click on the Refresh Shaders Pack button in Minecraft to make this shader visible. As you can see, I now also have BSL installed. To activate a shader pack, simply click on the shader pack you want to use and click Apply at the bottom of the screen. With done, I return to the video menu and again I click on done and one more time on done to return to the Minecraft main menu. Now, when I start up a world, you will see that Minecraft has been drastically changed by the shaders you have installed. Because Iris Shaders behaves as a mod loader, you can also install other fabric mods with Iris Shaders in Minecraft. Enjoying the beautiful shaders alone is also so lonely, so invite your friends to join your awesome Minecraft server to enjoy the beautiful shaders together. For less than $20 a month, you already have a 4GB Minecraft server at Apex Hosting, the most awesome Minecraft server host on the web. Click the top link in the description to take advantage of 25% off your first invoice or support this channel at patreon.com/narnicle to access our Minecraft 1.17 survival server. Did this video help you to install shaders in your Minecraft 1.17 installation? I'd really appreciate it if you could leave a like. And don't forget to subscribe for a lot more upcoming Minecraft stuff. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all again in the next video.